Good afternoon, everyone. I'm going to take you through a few quick points, all right? So good part of today, you all have spent sort of learning and understanding what you're going to be doing in your village visit. And we've also discussed rural life in our deconstruction week, and that's been a very eye-opening experience for many of us who have never been to a rural area. And most of the images that come to our mind when we think about a village would be agricultural farms, a lot of poverty, a lot of discussions around that, lack of infrastructure, the quality of life, droughts, Narega, Gram Sabha. All of these are correct, right? But we've also learned through all these sessions that there is a lot more to a rural life than that. What we've also seen that, you know, this sort of romanticism that often gets attached with the village is not always that true. There are a lot of complexities, a lot of hierarchies, a lot of cross-cutting identities, relationships, and they all work at cross purposes at times as well. We know all of this because we've talked about it here. Some of you have lived these experiences as well, but in your own respective states and in your own respective districts. So what is this field study research program all about? What you all really need to understand clearly is this and the subsequent slide. These are the two most important slides for you, okay? The objectives of this entire program is to sensitize you towards the rural life firsthand. So we've talked about it, we've discussed it. Even those of you who come from a rural background, you have a limited understanding of what you have seen in your areas. But once you go to the field, you will see that it actually some things may be common, but there are many things which are actually different from one place to another. And the idea is that now that all of you are going to be serving all over the country, you should have an understanding, a sense of what goes on in different parts of it. And the focus of the districts that have been chosen for you are all the districts which are neighboring the border. We are with neighboring international borders, okay? So that is in many ways the most remote villages and districts of our country as well. Sensitizing you towards that and understanding the socioeconomic and political dynamics of the village, that's something we have talked about. We want you to see it in play. Understanding the problems faced by rural people, especially the marginalized and the vulnerable. And as you must have learned in your PRA exercises today, they are often the ones who are most silent. They're often the ones who you will have to make a lot of effort to make them come forward and share their opinion. And you will experience that, you'll feel that. Learning how to evolve people-based solutions to local problems. As bureaucrats and civil servants, you know, we all love to sit in a room. We think we know everything because we studied so much. We're all very intelligent. So we think that we have the answers to all the problems. We will give our solutions, and when they fail, or when they run for a short time and then they stop working, we tend to blame it on the people. Inko to samajh hi nahi aata. They don't know how to appreciate our wisdom. But if you really want long-lasting results, long-lasting impact of anything, the only way to do that is to understand the local perspective and to evolve people-based solutions to problems. All of you are going to be in different positions across the country, and every single one of you, whatever decisions you take, is going to impact the last man in the village that you're going to be visiting. You have to have that perspective. As Sanjay Ji was just telling me, Honorable Prime Minister has often said this, that you may know all the theory in the world, you may know all the legal acts, rules, everything, but unless and until you know the lives of people in a village, the most backward and the most out of reach kind of villages, you will never be a good civil servant. And that is the core purpose of why we're sending you out there. Understanding the awareness about sanitation and hygiene, it being one of our flagship programs, you all know about the Swachh Bharat mission, but to see how it is playing out there. Similarly, evaluating the working of various village level institutions. Once again, there's nobody in this room who doesn't know what the 73rd Amendment is. You all know the history, geography, everything of it. But how does it actually translate? What really goes on? Is it the same as what happens in the villages that you all come from? And at this point, all the points that I've mentioned here, I would also want you all in your reports to reflect back upon your pre-FC village visits that you did. You all went to different institutions, you all made certain visits, and you will be going to a very different cultural context now. So what is the story there? Is there a continuum? is there a very stark difference? Why is it that some things work somewhere and some things don't work in other places? I want you to analyze critically everything that you see and evaluate changes as a result of governmental and non-governmental interventions in the villages that you go to. There may have been some, there may not have been some. But look at the historical perspective, what has worked, what hasn't, why. And here, when I say evaluate, please don't confuse it with judgment. We do not want you to sit in judgment over the village or the village officials or the people. Evaluation here refers to your own understanding. Evaluate from the perspective of the theory, from the perspective of your pre-FC visits, and understand it for yourself. So the key takeaway from this slide, the key words are, what are the key words? Understand and learning. You're going there to understand and to learn. You're not going there to teach them. You're not going there because you know everything and you have all the solutions and we want you to transmit them. You're not going there because you are the messiah they are waiting for. Okay? You are their guests. They are your hosts. Please behave accordingly.
You've been here a fortnight. I think a lot of friendships have been made. Group is very active. I must compliment all of you for the way you have really discharged yourself. Really. So congratulations. Great job, because we hear this, you know, from batchmates, colleagues, people who pass through. It really builds a huge sense of, you know, faith in ourselves that we are capable of being what we are capable of being. And I'm so glad that you have demonstrated that. I really wanted to talk to you today because you will be leaving the academy for the first time. And I wanted to tell you the implications. And frankly, I haven't made my thoughts. I was just trying to do that and I was pulled out. So, but I'll speak from my heart. Village visit, Bharat Darshan, is such an important part of your career that, believe me, for the next 35, 36 years of your career, this will cast long shadows, very long shadows. Do not underestimate the implication of this particular 15 days, 20 days, whatever. This time, thankfully, the COAST team has made a very elaborate arrangement, so you're getting a lot of exposure to India. But this is the most critical time when you will form a few things. First, you will form your character. Believe me, these are the 15 days, 20 days in which all of us will form our character, because this is the time, for the first time, when the rest of the ecosystem is interacting with us, trying to deal with us, ki bhai nahi, aap to bade sahab ho, aap to bade ye ho, aapke liye chota sa kuch bhej diye, aapke liye aur kuch kar rahe hain. You will find that you'll be surrounded by a huge amount of temptation, small and big, right? And this is the occasion, believe me, take it, please write it down, etch it in your heart. Learn that you will not accept anything free in these 15, 20 days. Once you start the discipline of rejecting all these minor temptations, your character is built. In my own experience, I have seen how in this process of 10, 15 days, because it looks like a very small thing. It's a kya chota sa memento hai, kisi ne kuch kar diya. Maybe it was a dinner, maybe it was something else. It is courtesy, you know, he is recognizing me. You know, all this kind, we will rationalize and justify. But this, it is that one small step that will lead us in different directions. And as they say, you lose your character only once, right? You can't lose it again and again. You lose it once, you've lost it. So please hold on to it, because this is something I really feel. There's nothing else that I can convey to you. Learn this as one thing, as from a senior, well-wisher, elder, telling you, protect this, defend it, number one. Number two, you will form impressions about each other. In these 15, 20 days, each of you will form your own impression about the other. What President Kalam Sahib used to speak, I found it a very beautiful way of explanation. He said, we are all individually building our brand image. Whatever is our brand, when you look at, let us say, Pushpinder or somebody, Hitesh, whoever, you say, okay, what does he stand for? In our ecosystem, in government, it is always the impression we have about the person that will almost judge, almost decide how even official matters are processed. I have seen in my own life, files would come, you're just seeing, you just see who was the last person who signed. When you know the last person who signed is a very meticulous man, you would usually not spend so much time on it. That is the brand image. And this is the only thing, because this is actually a question that was asked to President Kalam. People, young people like you, asked him, sir, how can we defend ourselves? Because it, we find that we are constantly a target. If we find that we might be on the wrong side, we might be wrongfully punished. How do we defend ourselves? His answer was this. If you have a brand, and if you have a brand image, which will communicate to the rest of the world what you stand for, that is what will defend you. And I'm asking you, please start building it now. Because all of you will be in touch with each other. Maybe you'll meet only once in 30 years, maybe. Luckily, with this common MCTP, you'll definitely meet 20 years from now. Earlier, 30, 35 years, there's no chance you're going to meet anybody. So 20 years later, when you come back, what are the impressions you're going to come back with? This is the brand image I'm talking about. And the point I'm making is, character is made in these. All the advice that you got from your seniors, well-wishers, this is what this is all about. Third, remember, you are also representing what the civil service stands to all our colleagues in the larger ecosystem earlier. In our times, in fact, slightly ahead of our times, maybe 60s, 70s, it was given as a carte blanche. There was a certain bank balance that was given, and everybody was expected to have it, and you were given a very long rope. So when I went to my Kadar state, it was a very interesting state. He said, you know, all of you are given a very long rope. You can swing on it or hang with it. Put it and hang. There were people who hung themselves. The point I'm making is, those batches, those years, society was much more kinder. Perhaps it was much more indulgent. Perhaps they had lesser information. Perhaps we were not on test every day, every second, every small thing. And so it is very important that all of you collectively represent what you stand for, that you stand for professionalism, that you stand for courtesy, that you stand for service, etc. Because it is only when all of us behave collectively that we will be able to build our common character. That's the third. Fourth, you would have noticed that we are also trying to do something from the academy side. And you have been part of it. What we are trying to communicate to the larger world, world at large, is what do we, all of us, the civil service, stand for? What are our, as I try to describe, what are our gold standards of behavior, of attitudes, disposition, etc., etc.? We are trying to do, including what we learn here. Because last 3-4 years, one of the things I had to constantly hear was that perhaps you're not giving what is needed there. Perhaps you were, there are some of you from the 94th FC, right? Would you mind just putting up your hands? Yeah, few of you. Yeah, so those days, I hope I am wrong, but this was the accusation. I was handling training on the other side. So we used to be told that most of the trainees who'd come here already know what you are telling them. What is it new that you are giving them? What is that edge? What is it that they don't teach you at Harvard? So we are trying to make that difference this time to communicate to the larger society outside, our colleagues outside, so that when you call, when you go out, each of you represents that difference. Each of you are tested against that particular standard, so that by default, each of you is given that small pedestal, not a very large pedestal, but you are given a pedestal saying that no, that this group, these officers who have gone through this rigorous exposure, rigorous training, rigorous, I would say, immersion, are different from everybody else. A person who has taken the exam with you and whose results have come, after 3 months, you are definitely different from that person. We all know that in margin of few marks, there are people outside of the list, there are few people inside of the list, right? In 3 months, believe me, you are different from those who have been left behind, right? I think you would all agree. But we want society to accept that. We want the larger system to accept that. And we want them to accept not because of some kind of a mute faith, but because we are telling them that these officers, these trainees, are being given that kind of an exposure. They are being given understanding of a nature that will never be available to anybody. In fact, there will be tons of your seniors who would not be experiencing the kind of things you will be experiencing in the next 15 weeks. I can guarantee you that. But that is the difference we want to make, and that is the standard we want to set. So all the best. Enjoy yourselves. I will be talking to you, hopefully, in the Statue of Unity.